Welcome to Chamber Chat. I'm Judy Taylor, president of the Habersham County Chamber of Commerce. Thank you for joining us. My guests today include Clint Smith with the Apple Mountain Golf Club, the Member of the Month, and Habersham Commissioner Stacy Hall. And my first guest is Clint Smith. Welcome, Clint.
Hey, how are you, Judy?
Doing great, and thank you for being on Chamber Chat.
Glad to be here.
And Clint, you are the head golf professional at Apple Mountain Golf Club.
Yes, ma'am.
But Clint, you are not new to Habersham County, and I don't think you're new to Apple Mountain Golf Club.
No, ma'am.
Tell us a little about your background.
Okay, well, my wife and I moved up in, January 1st, 1999. Not to move to into the golf business at that time, but we were getting away from South Georgia. I'd graduated with a business degree from Valdosta State University. Mm-hmm. And in the meantime, while I was...
Let me stop you.
Okay.
Were you on the golf team there?
Yes, I was.
At Valdosta State?
Yes.
Okay, I thought you might have been.
Yes, and at that time, I didn't really have a so-called plan, but an opportunity came about. I met Jeff Davis at that time, who was also just moving to town. He was the director of golf at Apple Mountain prior to me and when I first got up here, but he moved permanently February of that year of 1999. And one day we just happened to be chatting and he said, you know what, I could use an assistant golf professional. And there it went, and I stayed 6 years at Apple Mountain and moved up into the ranks of golf professional and really loved it. Got out of the business for about 10 years, but glad to be back.
Well, we're glad to have you back in Habersham County, Clint. Have you and your family, I believe, do you have one child or two?
I have two. I have an 11-year-old daughter that attends Tallulah Falls, mm-hmm. and now I have a 15-month-old daughter. So a little bit of age difference mm-hmm. there, but I tell you, it keeps keeps us busy, my wife and I, Angie.
I saw that baby, the 11-month-old. Clint, recently you hosted one of the Chamber's Business After Hours.
I think it was a great event, too.
It was.
I really had fun mm-hmm. meeting some of the business associates of Habersham mm-hmm. County that I didn't know. There were a lot of familiar faces there as well.
Well, the people who came had a good time. That's what I look for in our business after hours. We had a good attendance. We did not have an extraordinary attendance. We had a good attendance. But what I noticed was people were enjoying themselves. And one thing was that you told us at the business after hours event, you told us about so many improvements out there. And some were to the clubhouse. Let's start off with the clubhouse. Tell our audience listening, what have you done to that clubhouse?
Well, Judy, the clubhouse was built back in the early 90s, and without a lot of work done on it in that time frame, it needed a little bit of an upgrade and mm-hmm. a little bit of a facelift. They had done a minor facelift before the resort operations had, but we wanted to go in and give it not necessarily a new look, but a clean look, a little bit different paint scheme, new carpet. We've added a hitting bay where we have a launch monitor and we can tweak someone's swing, fit for golf clubs if we need to, mm-hmm. as well as when it's inclement, people could come in and hit a few shots. So mm-hmm. that's nice. We're also planning to add some food and beverage operations down the road, and mm-hmm. we wanted to make sure our dining area would accommodate at least a good group of people inside. Mm-hmm. And we've added a new deck onto the back so we can host events and let our golfers enjoy a little bit of sunshine and nice weather. Mm-hmm. Of course, Habersham County has such great weather almost year round. Mm-hmm. That way they can be outside and have a snack or talk about their round.
Mm-hmm. And that deck is beautiful.
Well, thank you
very
much.
The night of the business after hours, people were going out on the deck, coming in. We were just having a good time.
It's been a great addition.
And it is so pretty. Well, tell us about the golf course itself. Now, have you made improvements there, too?
Well, we're always trying to improve. I will tell you, my right-hand man, Fred Williams, our golf course superintendent, who's been at the golf course for 18 years, is just an exceptional partner of mine, and he works really hard to always maintain the golf course in the top condition that it can be. But we are looking to improve in a lot of areas, not necessarily to make it more difficult, because that's one of the attractions of our golf course, is it's very player friendly. Mm-hmm. Anyone can come out, have a good time, not lose a lot of golf balls, mm-hmm. but we want to make it a little bit more challenging for the better golfers. So mm-hmm. we're adding a few tee boxes. You don't have to play them, but if you choose to back up a little bit, you can, and we're also really pushing hard to make sure that the playability and the condition of the course is just getting better and better. We're held to very high standards. Our public and our play, the golfers, they expect great conditions when they get there. So we're really trying hard to elevate our conditions to as good as anywhere.
Well, it's beautiful out there now. I can tell you that it's very pretty. Clint, I know you are a public golf course.
We're a resort golf course.
Yes.
Or semi-private is how I would most likely. Resort semi-private, because we do have memberships. It is open to the public.
Okay,
yes.
Well, tell us about your memberships, and can can just anybody go out there and golf?
Absolutely. Okay. We offer public play golf, where you just call, make a tee time, or go online and make a tee time, and pay a green fee and a cart fee. Come out and play Monday through Sunday. But we do have a pretty large group of members that enjoy their green fees are, so to speak, paid for, but they also get other benefits, discounts. We have member tournaments. We have member outings where they can enjoy a little bit of socialization with the other members. But it is not closed to members only. But it's just, it's a good idea to be a member, because you get a lot more bang for your buck, so to speak.
Oh, I'm sure you do. You can play as often as you want to.
You can play as often as you want to.
For a certain fee.
Right. Members, they just pay a cart fee. Public pays cart and green fee, which it varies from weekday. And we have specials during the week. But weekends, of course, would be our prime time.
Right. But you're very affordable, and also it's just very pretty out there. It really is. Well, tell us, Clint, what is the golf course or that part relationship with the resort itself?
Okay, for a very brief history lesson, when the course was built, it was not part of the resort, obviously. And then Silverleaf Resorts came in and bought the golf course to be an amenity for the what is now the timeshares that are there. Silverleaf was purchased by Orange Lake Country Clubs and Holiday Inn Vacation Group, and now they are run as a separate entity from us, but we're part of the same company. We're still an amenity of theirs, but we're under a slightly different umbrella, where we're under profit centers and they're actually under the resort operations. But we are affiliated with the resort,
yes,
Holiday Inn Vacation Club.
Well, tell us quickly, we got about 30 seconds left. What are some of your plans for the future?
Oh, we've got lots of plans. One is to increase our member-based enjoyment, adding more tournaments, more golf tournaments, of course, doing a lot of benefit tournaments. We're going to add a food and beverage operation coming down the road.
In the clubhouse.
In the clubhouse,
that
yes.
That will be so nice.
Yes, that'll be nice. And just to keep improving, and we're really being seen as one of the top fun places to play golf in any area, but especially in Habersham County.
Yes, you are. And Clint, you're doing a great job out there.
Thank you. I'm really enjoying it.
Well,
it's a lot of fun.
You can tell you do, and you're doing a great job, and you're putting new ideas to work out there, and we do appreciate it very much.
Thank you, Judy.
And thank you for being on Chamber Chat. And we're going to take a short commercial break and be right back. Please stay with us.
If it's one thing we love, it's watching TV. With today's busy lifestyles, we're finding ourselves away from our television a lot more. As a Windstream cable customer, you can still watch your favorite entertainment with Watch TV Everywhere. It's TV you want, when, and where you want it, with access to over 50 channels, all free as our cable customer. Just go to WatchTVEverywhere.com and start enjoying an incredible on-the-go viewing experience from Windstream Cable Television.
This spring, shop QVC.com to refresh your wardrobe, replant your garden, and rejuvenate your look. Find great brands and new deals every day. And get $5 off your first order with code 54U. At QVC.com, find what you love, love what you find.
Thank you for staying with us. My next guest is Kendra McCoy with the Hampton Inn, and they are also the Chamber's Member of the Month. Welcome, Kendra.
Thank you for having me, Judy.
I appreciate your being on, and congratulations on being Member of the Month.
It is quite an honor. I really do appreciate it.
Well, in just a second, our audience will know why you're a member of the month. We will get into some of the community things that you have done that made the Chamber Board vote Hampton Inn member of the month. But let's just start off, Kendra. When did the Hampton Inn in Cornelia open its doors? Because I think it was before I moved up here, maybe. I'm not sure.
I don't know when you moved up here, but we opened August 8th of 2001. And we have been steadily opened. Even through the renovation, we stayed open.
So you have been open now for 16 years. 16 and a half years. And I know that during that time, you're always doing updates. You know, you're changing this, you're improving this or whatever. But when was your last big renovation?
We did a complete renovation year 2014 and 15. It finished in August of 2015.
So what you have now is very fresh.
Very fresh. Yes. It's an all new look from top to bottom.
Mm-hmm. It is, and it looks very pretty too. Very clean, very pretty. Tell us about your guest rooms, the different options available, you know, bed options, so forth. Tell us about that.
Well, we're a non-smoking hotel. For those who are smokers, we do have two smoking areas, one out front and one out back. But all of our rooms are non-smoking. There is choice of one king bed or two queens, and we have the different handicapped options as well. We have a room with a rolling shower. We have several with the handicapped bars at the tub and that kind of thing. We also have hearing accessibility.
Oh, okay.
So I think we have 15 of those.
Mm-hmm. Well, but how many total rooms do you have?
We have 81 rooms.
And it seems as if you must stay busy a lot of the time.
We do. We stay very busy. We our
occupancy rate or
right. Our season really begins about March, and we run until November. Mm-hmm. November, December, and January were kind of low, but then it picks right back up because sporting things from Piedmont College, mm-hmm. they come in. We have businesses that use us quite a bit. And, of course, your travelers during the
leaf season. Oh, it's hard to get a room during the leaf season. Oh, well, tell us, what does each room have? Now, you mentioned that you have the different bed options, king-size bed, double beds, whatever, I guess. The bed options. But what does each room have in it? Or is that optional, too?
All of it is the same, and we like to do that because years ago we only had fridges and microwaves in rooms that people requested, and it was an extra charge. Now we do not charge extra. There's a fridge and a microwave in every room. There's 32-inch television, which has HD channels. There is the iron and the ironing board, the blow dryer, coffee pot. Now it's a single cup coffee pot. It's not your glass carafe because we worry about the safety of children. Mm-hmm. And we have the desk area with the ergonomic chair. And we have free Wi-Fi in all of the rooms.
It sounds as if they're pretty well equipped.
They are equipped, ready for work or play.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And does free breakfast come with everybody who rents a room?
Yes. The free hot breakfast is there for anybody who gets a room.
Well, tell us what's on your breakfast bar. Do you get up and make it every morning, Kendra? I'm just teasing you.
No, but Miss Sherry and Miss Debbie work quite hard, and they have been there quite a long time. Miss Debbie, I think, is going on her 7th year now, mm-hmm. so she's been with us quite a while. We have fresh fruit, which is whole or cut up. So you're talking like bananas, apples, and oranges, and then you're also talking your strawberries, your blueberries, cantaloupe, and watermelon. Mm-hmm. Then we have the bread section, which has Danishes, muffins, scones, and things like that. Then we have whole grain cereals. We have make your own waffles with name brand toppings such as Ready Whip whipped cream and Oreo cookies and that kind of thing. And then we have steel cut oatmeal every single day, and you can put toppings on it. It has nut or berry blend. And then we have your hot bar, mm-hmm. and your hot bar has three options. It has the egg, it has the protein, and then it has a starch. And that will change daily. Mm-hmm. We don't have the same thing up there every day. Mm-hmm. Then we have our coffees and our tea and mm-hmm. hot chocolate.
Well, now tell me, does the coffee stay there and available all day long?
Yes, the coffee's available 24 hours.
So I figured the coffee was. But after a certain hour of the morning, 10 o'clock or something, you take up the breakfast food.
Correct. Breakfast is served 6 to 10 every day.
Well, let's talk about your amenities there.
Okay.
So tell us, what are some of your amenities?
We get free Wi-Fi. That is the biggest one, especially for your workers. And it's throughout the whole building. So if you want to sit by the pool and work on your internet, you can do that.
I want you to explain something.
Yes, ma'am.
I know that you called one of your amenities, more or less, the Hampton Guarantee.
Yes. The Hampton Guarantee states that you're going to have friendly service, clean rooms, a comfortable surroundings, 100% of the time. If you don't, we'll make sure that you don't pay for that evening. Mm-hmm. We take the charges off. And it's because we want you to have that quality. That's right. What it's all about, is to have the quality. Mm-hmm. We're a mid-scale hotel that we give you that comfortable service for the mid.
And it is a true guarantee, because I've mentioned to you that one time I was in a Hampton Inn in another town, and I just had one little problem that I didn't even call a problem. And the next morning I started to check out, and they said no charge. And I said, why?
Yes, because we want you to have that comfortable evening.
Well, let's talk about your fitness room. Now, you do have a workout center or a fitness room.
Right. We have a fitness center and a business center, and they're open 24 hours. Mm-hmm. You just need your room key to get in.
So Kendra, our time is almost up, and we've got to talk about why you're a member of the month.
Oh, yes.
And I just want to say that you recently, Hampton Inn, you do so much for the community. You support the Chamber of Commerce in so many ways. And one way is that you provide a meeting room there for one of our leads groups. But one of the main things is you recently made 50 blankets.
Yes.
And donated these to the Habersham Medical Center. Tell us a little bit about that.
Right. We made what they call no-sew blankets. You cut them out and you tie each of them, but each one had to be handmade, and it took about 3-4 hours for each blanket. And we wanted to make sure that everybody was comfortable and cozy and warm. So 20 of them went to the new babies over at the Habersham Family Birth Center, and 30 of them went over to the elderly at the Habersham home.
Yes. And we appreciate your service to the community so much. And you support so many other organizations, too. And the Chamber is just one of them. But I do know that you do, and you may want to quickly say some other organizations.
The Habersham Soup Kitchen. We serve every first and third Tuesdays.
You yourself, you go there, right?
Yes, I do.
You and your husband?
My husband and myself, Sherry, the breakfast host, one of the breakfast hostess, and Mike. We do it every other Tuesday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you for all that you do.
Well, we really love this community, and we want to give back.
Well, thank you, and thank you for being on Chamber Chat. We're going to take another short commercial break and be right back. Please stay with us.
This spring, shop QVC.com to refresh your wardrobe, replant your garden, and rejuvenate your look. Find great brands and new deals every day. And get $5 off your first order with code 54U. At QVC.com, find what you love, love what you find.
Thank you for staying with us. And my last guest today is Habersham County Commissioner Stacy Hall. And he has something very exciting to discuss with all of us today. Welcome, Stacy.
Hey, Judy. Good to see you again.
It's so good to have you back.
Thanks for having me.
And Stacy, I have gotten so excited about what you're going to be talking about.
There have been big events going on last week or so, yeah.
Yes, yes. But Stacy, you as a county commissioner have created a citizens committee to preserve and protect the oldest tree, white oak.
The oldest white oak tree in Georgia, and one of the top 10 oldest white oaks in the United States, right here in Habersham County, and in fact in my district, District 1.
That is exciting.
Yep. And it's located up near right in the same property our new fire station is on, Fire Station 17, at the corner of Bear Gap and Orchard Road. A lot of folks know about that tree. They probably don't realize that it's between 330 to 400 years old, which means it was an acorn in 1670, Judy. Isn't that amazing?
It is just hard to conceive of that it was an acorn in about 1670.
And since we've kicked this campaign off, I've had a lot of people come up to me and tell me about their stories and how they've played around that tree and been around that tree and grew up with the tree and that kind of thing. So it's it is certainly a part of Habersham County and has been for a long time.
It is. And let's talk about the committee and the purpose of the committee, Stacy. It has a twofold committee.
Yes. Well, let me. I'll back up just a minute and why what got us started on this process, and that's when we built the fire station this past fall. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of concern by area residents that we protect the tree, that we don't damage it when we built the fire station. So we took great. The county took great care in making sure we didn't disturb anything with the tree. And during that process, we had a certified arborist look at the tree to judge its health and come to find out it's in great health. Mm-hmm. It's a little past its prime, mm-hmm. still good looking.
Mm-hmm. Still got a few years
it's
left.
It's got about a 50 to 100 years left mm-hmm. if we take care of it. So it's in good shape. It's not as tall as it used to be, but it's 136. Tree canopy is 136 feet wide, which is massive.
It is.
66 inches at DBH, which is the diameter of the tree at breast height, which is how they measure trees. So it's mm-hmm. in good shape. So then there several citizens came up to me, since it's in my district, and voiced their concern that they want to for the county to continue to protect that tree. And we got to thinking, okay, what's the best way to do that? And how can we possibly leverage that tree into some educational opportunities and possibly even tourism, which I know you're excited about.
Yes.
For the county. So what we want to do is build a protective fencing, nice looking fencing around the apron of the tree.
Mm-hmm.
We want to build a nice looking boardwalk that will go to the trunk of the tree. Along the boardwalk, we'll have some educational signage that talks about the importance of preserving our natural resources, mm-hmm. such as that tree.
Mm-hmm.
We'll talk about the significance of that tree,
mm-hmm.
And it'll talk about the local history that's happened while that tree's been alive. And I think that we can do it in a way that will provide a fantastic educational platform for young people in our community. So hopefully we want to get the schools involved mm-hmm. and that kind of thing. So we've been looking at some other like situations and how we can incorporate some of their ideas. And
you've also been looking at other states and or other towns or places.
Yes, and what they've done and how they've leveraged that and how it's helped some tourism. And we mm-hmm. think it'll be beneficial to our community.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I definitely do.
So the two, just real quick, so the two goals of the committee, first, preserve and protect the tree.
Mm-hmm.
And then second is to leverage our available resources to create educational opportunities about preservation and natural resources in our environment to young people.
Right. And now I want you to tell our audience how you are hoping to mm-hmm. raise the money mm-hmm. to do mm-hmm. this.
Absolutely. Well, we always take donations. So if somebody wants to write a check. And we just had a donations from All About Monroe, which is a new company, a new business that's coming into Habersham. I'll let you talk to our folks about that. But
well, let's just go ahead and say that All About Monroe.
Because they just joined the chamber.
They just joined the chamber, and they will be opening this month in Demarest. They're just right on Highway 441, mm-hmm. All About Monroe, and it is a full-service spa. It is a medical spa. It is a it has all the services of any mm-hmm. spa.
Was it a hair dry bar?
It is.
Yeah, you have to educate me on that one, Judy. Maybe another time.
Another time.
I'm not
familiar. Because
that's
a whole story within itself. But it is a full service spa, and they are opening, and so they wanted to do something for the county, and they made a great donation.
They're very kind, very gracious, and we certainly appreciate this. Their $5,000 support.
Yes. From the Emersons in Rabun County.
That's right. So aside from, so we got donations, we're taking donations. Aside from that, there's a local artist by the name of Richard Smith, mm-hmm. who this past January during the snowstorm in Habersham went out and took a picture of the tree. Beautiful, beautiful picture of the tree. And he's created digital prints and canvas prints that have been brushstroked. And we are selling those through the chamber.
Absolutely. They're available at the chamber.
So you can go online and look at it at mm-hmm. georgiasoldestwhiteoak.com. That's mm-hmm. georgiasoldestwhiteoak.com. And then you can, there's a order form that you can download on the website as well. You can send that to the chamber. Or you can go to the chamber and look at the digital print in person, fill out the order form there. You can use credit cards or checks or cash, mm-hmm. anything like that. It usually takes, I think, about 2 or 3 weeks to deliver. I've ordered one. Mm-hmm. A lot of folks are starting to order one.
Well, I think you can get a print the next day.
Okay.
You can get a print the next day. But Richard Smith does say for the canvas to allow 2 to 3 weeks.
And proceeds from that are going to our fund. Mm-hmm. And our goal is to raise $20,000 mm-hmm. for the fencing, the boardwalk, the educational signage, and general landscaping mm-hmm. so it looks pretty good.
But the donation certainly got us started.
The donation got us big time kickstarted. So mm-hmm. they can buy a print. They can provide a donation. I think we're trying to get a chili supper at the fire station mm-hmm. Scheduled, which hopefully mm-hmm. we'll be announcing right. that soon.
You know, from the interest that I've heard so far, I don't think we'll have a problem with it.
I don't think so.
But I want anybody who's interested to contact the chamber for this print. And if you're from Habersham County, you just need to see this print.
Yeah, and you know, one point, I've got to make this point because I've had a number of people ask me, so what? It's an old tree. There's a lot of old trees. It is an old tree. Well, it's a beautiful old tree, but it's not just about that tree. Yes, we want to protect and preserve our natural resources, which are vital to Habersham mm-hmm. County, but we want to use it as an educational opportunity for our young people. As a career educator, and I know you're an educator, mm-hmm. that's very important to me and to you and to a lot of folks. We need to teach our children how to take care of our resources, and this tree is a great opportunity to do that.
It is. And Stacy, when you think about that tree was there before the Declaration of Independence was mm-hmm. signed,
that's
before
right.
we were a nation,
that's right,
and that it was there when Native Americans were mm-hmm. here, mm-hmm. maybe playing under it or having powwows under it.
Yeah.
It's just awesome. It is. It's just hard to comprehend. But, Stacy, our time is up. But I always end with a quote. My quote today is inspired by you and the tree. And the quote is, "He who plants a tree plants a hope." And that's by Lucy Larcom. Thank you for joining us today. I'll see you next time.